Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Jan Sewing Solutions. Now, if you're a regular viewer of my channel, then you'll be aware that I haven't been active for the last 4 weeks. Now, the reason was that I had a death in the family, and due to circumstances, I had to rush off to Pakistan, and so it's been a hectic few weeks, a little bit disturbing few weeks. Anyway, life goes on, and it's a last minute tutorial of this suit for innayah for Eid. I didn't make anything else, as one, I didn't have time, and secondly, I've not really been in a mood for sewing due to the family circumstances. Okay, so today is a day before Eid, and I've sort of like rushed and made her a last minute suit. Now, for the children this year, we organized a sort of a get together for children where they can enjoy themselves, and we hired a bouncy castle, and you know, just so that the adults can get on with their own stuff, the children can have a little bit of a playtime. Now, when children are wearing fancy clothes like these long dresses and so on, it's difficult for them to move around. So what I've done is I've done a three-piece outfit for her, and I've tried to simplify it so that she can wear the jacket, but then she can go on to wearing simpler clothes. Now, this is a jamawar straight cut trousers that I've made for her. These are a very, very big rave for adults as well. I'm sure you would have seen many of the models wearing these. Now, sometimes these are buttoned on the sides, and most of the time these are sewn unlined. For innayah, what I've done is I've sewn this trouser and I've fully lined this. One, to make it comfortable, and two, to give it a little bit more stability. It's actually quite a thin fabric, and it doesn't really have a very long life expectancy. Also, it tends to fray a lot, so this is a very, very easy way of doing this. One, it takes away the need for overlocking, because all the stitching is done on the inside. There is no seaming. It's basically been turned over from where it's been elasticated, and that's where all the final stitching is taken to. To go with this pants, I've just done her a straight, sort of a shortish tunic dress, plain, just putty at the front. I've just got to button this up. I have piped it all along, just to give it a little bit of a delicate touch. So it's Banarsi piping all the way. It's full sleeves, but it's a comfortable short tunic that she can run around in, and she doesn't have to worry about, you know, tripping over or jumping about on the bouncy castle, and then this getting in her feet and so on. I have made her a jacket, because I want her to wear this when she's obviously when she's not playing around. So plus the attraction obviously is in all this. It's a simple enough suit. It hasn't taken me that long to do, and hopefully anyone who follows the instructions will find it easy to make as well. I will give innayah, when she's wearing this, I'll give a live demonstration of what it looks like. But it's a simple suit, and very comfortable suit, and really that's what you want for children. Now, to go with this, I've just thrown together a net scarf for her, and this is one of those scarves that goes over the head, and she's got a purple abaya that I actually bought for her from Saudi Arabia when I went to Umrah, so she can wear this on top of that. You know, this is a little bit of the beads on the cap as well, so that's like a little bit of a fancier stuff to go on top of it, just to give it a little bit of the added touch. Now, this is thin, so she'd need to wear like a cap or something with it. I am rushed for time, so I haven't really had time to do anything else. I hope the future is a little bit brighter, and we'll come back and hopefully catch up with some more tutorials after Eid. Anyway, if I don't see you again, do all have a wonderful Eid, and remember me in your prayers, and enjoy your day, and don't forget to remember your loved and dear ones in your du'as, and inshallah I shall see you again soon.